top seed in the college football playoff is...
Touchdown, Georgia! And number one finally has the lead.
We didn't build this program on hoping for one-year wonders. We built the program to be sustained.
Show them how it's done.
Wow, this Michigan defense...
Now we have some tension.
TCU losing a close one in overtime against a top 10 opponent, even with the losses that keep them in, and do they hold three?
Can't stop going till I get to number one. Number one.
I don't know many people that would still be playing the game after hearing some of the injuries he's gone through.
All kinds of speed. Touchdown, TCU.
Ohio State, you know, playing the conference championship game, had the blowout loss. Alabama's got the closer losses.
It's Ohio State.
No, the Buckeyes are in.
Did the committee get it right? They did. And the playoff is set.
Number one.
TCU, they're a Cinderella story.
This has had the feel of a Disney movie all year long, particularly with Max Duggan in a starring role.
That small school down in Fort Worth, Texas, that, you know, has some guys that can play football, has a great fan base, and continues to fight.
In the Fiesta Bowl, that small school's resolve was immediately tested on the first drive of the game.
And it's a run up the middle. Edwards, daylight into the secondary, 40 to the 50. Can they catch him at the 30? Tackle down at the 20-yard line. 53 yards on the first play from scrimmage.
Fourth down, must have it moment. Double reverse, we got the Billy Special.
I think I was pretty pumped up using that momentum of the defense and having their backs and picking them up for what they just did and trying to get it scored.
J.J. McCarthy throws, and it's intercepted! Picked off and being brought back for a touchdown by Bud Clark!
Michigan finding out about TCU's speed, and TCU draws first blood in the desert.
Going into the season, unfortunately, I didn't win the job. But when you get your opportunity, I think you gotta make sure you make the most of it.
2.5 to go in the first quarter.
First and goal at the one. Snap back. Think the inside give. Duggan keeps. Takes on a tackle. And rolls over it. Into the end zone. Touchdown. TCU. Max Duggan scores.
All of you guys said it was going to be a blowout.
I did.
For Michigan.
Early in the second quarter, I was always testing again.
TCU's 14-3 lead. 13:43 to go first half.
Fires. Pass broken up. It's intercepted. It is Rod Moore on the tip.
The momentum's changing. The momentum's changing. They want to go deep after the takeaway, and they do go deep. Rowan Wilson. Touchdown, Michigan.
This may be reviewed.
Did he catch it at the 1 yard line with contact down?
I think he was in the end zone. I don't think he had it when he first went down.
We're going to waste our time looking at this one again.
After review, the ruling is a catch, but the runner was down a half yard short of the goal line.
I mean, maybe a half inch with his backside on the turf.
I'm surprised. I thought it was a touchdown.
Michigan gets right up to the line. McCarthy under center. It is an inside handoff.
TCU defense.
I have a heart condition that I've had since birth, and I had a 9-hour procedure, and then 2 days later I had a blood clot from the surgeries.
TCU a 14-3 lead over Michigan. It is a play action pass down the left side, wide open. Quentin Johnston, catch of the 25, spins at the 20.
We talk about the arm, we talk about the legs, we talk about the toughness. That was the brain from Matt Stoney right there.
It kind of just puts a stop in your life. You don't really realize the implications that it might have, and it can be taken away just like that. So I think being grateful, being in the moment of where you're at, where your 2 feet are, just a great spot to be here at TCU.
5 minutes left in the second quarter.
Duggan got hit, still got it off. Tay Barber! Touchdown, Horned Frogs!
McGregor and and Samer still are going to blitz. And Barber's crossing, but watch Duggan. He knows he can't block them all. He's just got to get back far enough to give himself time to let the speedy Barber clear.
At the end of the first half and into the third quarter, Michigan made a push.
It's a line drive. Looks like he has plenty of leg. And the legend grows off the foot of Jake Moody. Career long 59-yarder.
Let's go!
Watch your feet! Watch your feet! Duggan fires down the middle, and it's tipped and intercepted. Mikey Sanders still comes up with it inside Michigan territory, and the Michigan defense has turned the football over. Battered, bruised, but not dead yet.
I feel a shot coming.
Oh, I told you!
Still in control, and that, you know, we're playing well and not worrying about what's going on right now, staying in that mindset.
McCarthy, four receivers, looks, fires, and picked off. Dee Winters grabs it at the 20, at the 15, to the 10. Touchdown!
Michigan scored on their next possession to make it 34-22.
For a while, the momentum just kept swinging back and forth.
Imari DiMercato tripped up. He had a lot of green grass. Approaching the final minute of the third quarter.
Snap, handoff, DiMercato, first down and more to the 40-yard line. Linebacker can't catch him at the 45 to the 30. DiMercato inside the 10, and he's knocked down just shy of the goal line. 69 yards.
Here, Duggan keeps it this time. He's going to dive through. Touchdown, Max Duggan.
Oh, no, this is over, guys. It's over. It's over.
If they can score again the way they did the last series, it might be on life support, but we are moving.
JJ fires over the middle. Ronnie Bell's got it. 20, 15, 10. Ronnie Bell reaches for the end zone. Touchdown.
I think this is going to be not only reviewed, but overturned and brought back to about the half-yard mark.
There won't be an inside handoff to Khalil Mullings this time, will there?
It is a give to Mullings, and he's into the end zone for a touchdown.
Back and forth they go here in the third quarter.
To DiMercato up the middle, and he fumbles. The ball is out, and Michigan says they've got it, and they do.
Give to Wilson, coming around the right edge. Gets a ball to the 15. He's at the 5. He's up there.
That makes this a one-score game again.
And Max Duggan, again, has really not had a hot hand, but we've seen him get hot even when things aren't going great.
Huge third down and 7 here. Michigan blitzes. Duggan dumps it off short. Quentin Johnston has the first down, and off he goes. They are not going to catch him. No flag. It continues for TCU.
Michigan scored with 3 minutes left, and we led 51-45.
They got the ball back with 52 seconds left, needing a touchdown to beat us.
And Michigan is down to one last must-have play.
To the right, snap comes back, it hit the ground, it's loose on the ground. The Frogs bail on it, now Michigan's picked it up, but toss it back right. This game is over. TCU is going to pull off the stunning upset. The Horned Frogs are going to go to the college football playoff national championship game.
Hey, Fred, how are you?
You're headed to the national title. Where are your emotions right now?
Yeah, no, this is, you know, it's so exciting. You know, we're going to celebrate this one, but, you know, we got a bigger one coming up, and that's the one that we want. So, you know, that's one we're looking forward to.
At Papa John's, we start with better. Like our fresh, never frozen donuts.
Football playoff semifinal Saturday shifts to Atlanta, the epicenter of college football. And the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl hosts the semifinal for the third time. And it'll feel pretty much like a Georgia home game tonight.
It's been a long month, so it's time to go let it rip. We're going to go let it rip. Now, we're going to be physical early on and make plays, but it's going to be a long night. We're just going to swing as hard as we possibly can, look up after 60 minutes and see where we're at.
That's what they did, starting with the second possession of the game.
Stroud, deep drive, and looks and has Harrison wide open during Georgia territory. Stroud will now roll to the right again to the Georgia 40. Stroud fires deep down to the end zone, and it is grabbed in the end zone by Harrison for an Ohio State touchdown, 31 yards.
Did the Buckeyes draw first blood?
But it only took to the next possession for us to get back in the game.
Third down and about 10 coming up for Georgia. Bennett to throw. Deep ball to the near side. He's got Blaylock. He adjusts and makes the catch. Tremendous adjustment by Dominic Blaylock.
Bennett rolls out and puts it on the bootleg. And there is the first catch by Bowers. And the Dogs are threatening.
Quick pass to the outside. McIntosh gets free. And he takes it right up the middle for a Dogs touchdown. Kenny McIntosh for a 25-yard receiving touchdown.
What a first half here. I mean, back and forth, momentum shifts between these two heavyweights.
C.J. Stroud fakes the handoff, turns to his right, looking to throw back left side, shoots it upfield. Caught at the Georgia 26-yard line, and it's Harris wiggling his way through the defense. Wide to the right to the 20, and the ball knocked out of his hands, and Georgia's got a fall on it out of bounds.
Going to get the ball inside Williams. Powering forward, drives the ledge, and scores for Ohio State.
Steps up into the pocket, looks, and he fires up the left side. Neil Chambers intercepts it, brings it up the left side to the Georgia 30-yard line, and the Georgia native comes up with his second interception of the season, the third of his career.
Second and 9 from the 16-yard line. Stroud back to pass, being harassed, trying to extend the play, throws it to the end zone, where he's able to get it complete for a touchdown to Marvin Harrison.
Stroud, like a maestro. And here comes Stetson Bennett. What an amazing career. It's like a movie script and more chapters to be written.
Stetson takes it out of the shotgun. Deep ball down the middle. He's got a man breaking open, and it is caught. 14-yard line, Arian Smith. Smith got open, was waiting, and Bennett let it fly. Kendall Milton steps over a man, angles to the right, to the 5, to the 4, to the 3. They try to push him in the end zone. They do. Touchdown.
Huge answer right there by the Dogs. Dogs hanging in.
McIntosh brings the deep set back. And he's got the football. And he's got a crease. In the clear. McIntosh. One man to beat. Touchdown. Guys, stop. Oh, are you kidding me? The Turf Monster got him at the 10.
He looks back, and by looking back, he loses his balance. He walks into the end zone.
Second and goal. Bennett's going to run it himself to the left side and take it in just inside the pylon. A touchdown run by Stetson Bennett.
Ohio State scored late in the second to take lead at the half.
And they kept the momentum going into the third quarter.
First drive of the second half. Play action. CJ with nothing but time.
Oh.
Collision there in the back, and he's still down. Could be a game-changing play.
Without Trevion Henderson, without Jackson Smith and Chikba, without Kate Stover tonight, now without Marvin Harrison. So it's not just trying to put points on the board, it's what he's facing in trying to do that.
Early in the fourth, we were still down 11.
They're setting the punter out. Georgia, a lot of confusion. They weren't sure if Day was going to gamble again and go for it. And it's a fake! The ball is snapped, and it's Rossi. They called a timeout. Oh, Georgia just hit a timeout call. They sniffed it out.
After that, we just needed one play to turn the game around.
Stetson Bennett down 11, fourth quarter. Holy moly!
The sideline has come off.
Ohio State field goal left us down by 6 with 2.5 to go.
To defend our title, we would need a touchdown.
Here at 2:43, you get it within 6, and you have a chance to give it to your guy.
And it steps up, delivers down. Adam Garrett Jackson makes the catch at the 15.
15 yards away from making this thing happen.
From the 10, snap it back to Bennett. He looks in the end zone, looking for the back corner.
Oh, oh, touchdown, 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 AD Mitchell, back left corner.
Extends it, Bennett's crazy, unlikely, impossibly far-fetched career arc. Get any wilder.
Are you kidding me? What else could happen, right? Remember now, here's 54 seconds, and Ohio State has 2 timeouts, and they need a field goal.
You know, it would really be magical if we could win this right at the stroke of midnight. 10 minutes away.
They either have 35 yards to feel comfortable for Ruggles in a game-winning field goal. Long throw and a catch by Fleming, who's out across the 40. Steps out, saves the timeout.
With 39 seconds remaining, C.J. Stroud runs, tucks to the 50, to the other 45, to the 40. He's in field goal range immediately with a big run of 28 yards.
They're in range, but it's not super comfortable.
No. Noah Ruggles, a graduate transfer here earlier in the fourth quarter, hit a 48-yarder, which is his Ohio State long. His career long was 49 at North Carolina.
Ruggles is as steady as he comes. He's missed just 2 this year.
Noah Ruggles' life could be vastly different for the rest of his days. All he needs to do is kick a ball 150 feet through some very narrow posts.
Are you kidding me? 30 seconds to midnight? We got this going on? What the heck's going on?
Biggest moment of Noah Ruggles' collegiate football career.
From 50 with a win and a spot in the national championship game. Turned away. Never got it. He hooked it. And Georgia is going to survive at the stroke of midnight.
It's midnight. Happy New Year. Georgia 42, Ohio State 41. Oh, my goodness.
And the Dogs earn the right to defend their national championship in L.A.
How does it sound if we see you next week at the national championship?
If you had told me that when we were down, whenever we were down in the fourth, I'd be like, you are crazy. Yeah, well, we'll see you there.
National champion will be crowned tonight. Will it be Georgia trying to establish a dynasty? TCU, maybe one of the greatest upsets of all time.
You look at TCU, Kirk, and you have to ask the question, is the moment too big for them?
You can't be, let's ease our way in. You got to come out swinging early. I think TCU, my concern, honestly, is on the back end, one-on-one against Brock Bowers and those slot receivers.
That certainly was the plan, to test their secondary. And that happened as soon as Georgia got the ball.
Bennett wants to throw. Time in the pocket. He fires. Catch number one on pass number one of the night goes to Brock Bowers. He makes the grab. And a 21-yard completion to their leading receiver.
It's Milton around the left side. He is a physical runner. Runs with intent and purpose. And he's got a first down at the 21.
It's a fake handoff. Bennett keeps it around the left corner. Inside the 5, and he scores.
It's his mobility and his ability to make plays with his legs that ultimately won him the starting job last year.
They send a man in motion, Davis, and he takes the handoff on a jet sweep. Trying to turn the corner to the left. He lost the football at the 33-yard line, and there's a pileup. Georgia thinks they have it, and they do. For play fake, throws on the run. High leaping catch made by Ladd McConk. He got his feet in.
Ultra reliable, hasn't missed this season inside of 40 yards. It's a chip shot from 24. So Georgia builds a 10-0 lead midway first quarter.
But on TCU's next possession, we saw how explosive they could be.
Max Lucky takes a snap. Time. Oh! Takes a shot. Wide open, Darius Davis. Spinner, circle pop, dancing. Oh. Out of bounds.
Shotgun. Max keeps and will score. Touchdown, Duggan. Ninth rushing touchdown of the year for Duggan. Hit the horn here in Los Angeles.
And after that, the Bulldogs' game plan
really kicked in.
McConkey on the edge gets some blocks, and now McConkey looks like he's got some of that explosive ability back. It's an 11-yard gain. Solid chunks of yardage so far every time Georgia has run the football. First down, Bennett looked to pitch it to the edge, now picks it up, and now does find McConkey in some space. He's going to be wrestled out inside the 40s.
That sets up the throw. Pressure coming on. Wide open, McConkey reaches up high. Touchdown. Touchdown, McConkey. Nobody near him. Georgia 17 and TCU 7.
Fake pitch to the outside. Stenson.
Up for real.
Oh, no.
Time to Brock Bowers. Wow.
He's being used early and often tonight. That makes Georgia fans happy.
Bennett rolls out to the left to avoid the corner rush. Bennett's going to run. He's to the 40, to the 35. He dives for the first step. He got it.
Bennett keeping all the way and just sauntering into the end zone. His second rushing touchdown. And Georgia throwing haymakers and building a big lead now.
Duggan, deep throw down the middle. And it's intercepted. Over the head of Quentin Johnston and Javon Bullard.
The middle, catch made Bowers. Doesn't matter how many guys you put in coverage, they can't cover him or tackle him easily down to the 12.
Kendall Milton, touchdown Georgia. 1 yard scoring run by number 2, Kendall Milton.
And by the way, Georgia's not done in this half. If they get him off the field right now, they're not taking a knee.
Duggan stands and delivers, but it's intercepted. Made a mistake, and Javon Bullard has had a huge first half with takeaway number 3. And no, Georgia is not done in the first half.
Bullard has 2 picks and a fumble recovery.
Oh,
Stetson back the other way.
Hey.
One-handed, a touchdown!
Oh,
the Georgia Bulldogs.
A.D. Mitchell, who didn't have a catch from week 3 until the semifinal game, comes up big again.
It's been all Georgia. I don't even know what really to say except for complete domination.
They score in every possession, 5 touchdowns and a field goal.
Huggin didn't make the trip out here.
He did not.
Which is a shame for him. I'm sure he's enjoying this game back in Athens watching it.
And finish his career with 2 national championships.
Could argue going to be the most decorated quarterback in this college football playoff era.
Bennett looking right, throws to the end zone. And touchdown! Len McConkey!
Not done dominating yet.
Back to back, man. You do not see this in college football.
But the Georgia Bulldogs bludgeon their way to back to back. Glory, glory, Georgia, as the fight song says.
The most emphatic, dominant championship performance in the modern era of college football. And once again, the Georgia Bulldogs are national champions.
And it's my honor to present the national championship trophy once again to Coach Kirby Smart and the Georgia Bulldogs.